Hi everyone, welcome back to my animated series where I tell some of my life stories. Today's story is about what I consider to be my worst concert experience of my life so far, except for maybe that time I almost died at a Metallica concert in San Jose, California. At least that one was enjoyable until Mauro and I had to leave the front rows of general admission because we were about to get crushed. Hey Mario, as I write this and think back to that concert, did we have In-N-Out burgers then? I feel like we did, but they weren't anything special to me, so I forgot about them for 15 years. Anyways, okay, back to the worst concert story. This took place on March 4th, 2016. The artist heading this concert was late rapper and actor Earl Simmons, but most of you know him by his stage name, DMX. Now, most people my age grew up listening to his famous hit songs like X Gon' Give It To Ya and Rough Riders Anthem in the 90s. But I didn't know much about him back in 2016 because, well, I'm foreign and I was instead listening to Shakira when she wasn't mainstream. That's what I grew up on. My wife, however, loved DMX and she really wanted to go see his concert at Lupo's Heartbreak Hotel in Providence. Since it was her birthday, I decided to get her tickets. This was 2016 and DMX really wasn't that big of an artist at the time. His glory days were long behind him, so tickets were relatively cheap. About 36 in advance and 40 at the door. So I decided to buy a pair for Anna and I since I knew she'd enjoy this birthday gift. One of her best friends, Steph, was also coming with us since they both grew up listening to him, and I was happy that Anna would have someone to sing along with because I surely didn't know any of the lyrics. I believe we showed up around 7 p.m. that night because we wanted to get a good place to stand for the concert. This was a tiny venue compared to other major concert venues, so it was mostly just standing room, no seats. Doors must have opened around 7 or 8 o'clock, so we had managed to secure a pretty sweet spot inside. It was directly in front of the stage, but not in the lower area. We wanted to avoid any mosh pits if they happened. Wait, were there even mosh pits at a DMX concert? I don't know. The show started shortly after 8 with a DJ playing some music to start getting the crowd hyped up. I was expecting DMX to come out around 9 p.m. I wasn't sure if there would be any opening act or not. I don't recall the tickets having that information. But after the DJ played some music, a couple of young rappers came out on stage and performed a couple of songs. No clue who they were. Once they were done, the DJ kept hyping up the crowd in typical DJ fashion, asking if Providence was ready to get the party started. And Providence was ready, but I guess DMX was not. The clock on my cell phone hit 10 p.m., then 10:30, then 11. If you know me, you can only imagine what I was feeling like by now. Anna and Steph were also wondering where DMX was, but they seemed more patient and still hyped up for the show. Me, on the other hand, I was starting to think about what time we should call it quits because something was definitely up with the show. People were starting to get rowdy, and I think I heard some boos in the crowd. The DJ kept doing his thing, trying to control the crowd, and at some point during all this, I decided to hop on my phone and see if there had been any last-minute updates about the event. All I was able to find were some Facebook posts from people at Lupo's demanding for their money back and commenting how this was a waste of their time. Should I also be asking for our money back? I asked myself, but it was Anna's birthday gift, so it was really up to her. And she decided to wait a few more minutes to see what happened. Happy wife, happy life, right? She wasn't my wife at the time, but you know how the saying goes. So we decided to stay and wait. Some more time passed, and like a Disney fairy tale, the clock hit midnight, and from behind the curtains comes out DMX, 5 hours after we got there. The crowds burst into a loud chant, finally celebrating the start of the show they had all been waiting for. DMX starts singing, and that's when we realized this wasn't the same DMX from the 90s. I mean, physically, it was him, but the guy on stage could barely say 2 sentences before having to catch a breath. It was like he was forgetting the lyrics. What was going on? I said. It was clear that he was intoxicated or something. Nonetheless, Anna and Steph and most of the crowd was happy to see him on stage. Until he stopped singing and started doing push-ups. Yep, push-ups. Right on stage. Was this part of the show? No way. He was stopping mid-song to do this act of tomfoolery, so no way this was part of the show. At some point, he climbed up on top of the 10-foot speakers. It was a miracle he didn't bust his butt falling down. Anna actually thinks she has a picture of this somewhere in her photos gallery. Could this get any worse? I thought. Oh yes, yes it could. Those of you who know DMX's songs knows he likes to do these barking sounds like a dog. It's part of his trademark. Well, at this Lupa show, he started barking at some of the females in the front row, saying stuff like, "Ruff ruff, X gon' give it to you later tonight," or "X gon' make you a mommy by the end of the night," or "Woof woof, where the ladies at? Ruff ruff, I'm gonna beep all of you." Still, the crowd was happily screaming even though there was very little singing on his part. Now, could this get any worse? Certainly not, right? Wrong, it surely could. At some point in the middle of his wild performance, DMX thought that we all needed to be reminded why we were there. To praise Jesus, his Lord and Savior. That's right. This Rough Rider show had now turned into what I can only describe as a Sunday Southern Evangelical Mass. Praise this, sin that, yada yada yada. Somehow this guy had managed to merge Jesus with barking at the bimbos in the front row. It was at this point Anna and Steph started to finally wonder if they had made the right choice. Nothing against faithful people, I want to be clear on that. But we weren't here for midnight mass. And it seemed the crowd shared the same feelings because some had started to boo him. Some people started to walk out of the venue and I began to wonder if it was time to make our escape too. I left it up to Anna and Steph once again since this show was for them. After thinking it through, they said they had enough of the constant song interruptions followed by gospel preaching. It had not been a bad time for them. Anna tells me she still remembers having fun, but the show had turned weird, so it was time to go home. We left around 1 a.m. and headed home talking about what we had just experienced. I'm not sure if it was the same night or the next day, but I texted some co-workers about the concert. We used to share DMX memes in our work chat, so I knew that they'd enjoy what I had just gone through. Monday morning, when I returned to work, one co-worker in particular, Dave, sent me a local news article. DMX had checked himself into a rehab center and had canceled all future shows. I don't think I was surprised at all after seeing the events of Saturday night. It made sense he was seeking help. But sadly, as most of you probably know, he ultimately lost his battle with drug addiction some years later in 2021. He left behind a legacy of catchy songs, but most importantly for me, he left Anna and I the memory of this unforgettable concert night. So yeah, it was a very awful concert for me, but it does make for a great story that I hope you enjoyed. Let me know in the comments below if you had a bad concert experience as well, and I'll see you on the next episode. Thank you for watching.